received this request the other day, and I had a few spare moments, so I thought I would do it. Do you have a macro tutorial that will do all of the following? Filter a file based on category, say customer, and copy the filter data, save to a new file, then email the email address indicated in the file, and then repeat the process until all the criteria is filtered. Yeah, not quite the same. So I have a list of transactions that I've been pulling out for a few years here. So what I've done, so that's on sheet one. On sheet three, I have a list of customers and their the customer numbers and their emails. And obviously these are just made up emails. I just put I put the customer number and I put a gmail.com at the end of everything, just so that we know what we're doing. Is I've gone to sheet two. I have under the data tab, the data validation, I've hooked this to the list so it can pull, it's pulling up all of the customer numbers from here. So basically what you do is you can drop this down and select a customer number. I will show you how it looks when you run. So we've selected this number here, and what it's going to do is it's going to go and find all the records, all the transactions that have that customer number attached, and it's going to copy it to this sheet. And then what it's going to do is it's going to do a VLOOKUP. So it's going to look in here with this number, and it's going to look in this table and see what the email address is. And then when it's got the email address and all the records copied over to it, it's going to copy it and send it as an attachment. So let's run this. So here we have an email, and it says, please find a copy of your transactions attached. It's attached it as a PDF on here. And let's go back and see what it's attached. It's attached all the records that it could find with this number on it that happened in this last period of time. So let me show you the code. So basically what I've done is like a lot of dimming a lot of things here. So we have data sheet, port name, account number as what we're searching by, final row is as the end row, I as an integer, edress, this is very similar to my Outlook ones, edress is a string, subject is a string, message is a string, file name is a string, Outlook as an object, Outlook mail item is an object, my attachments as an object, path as a string, attachment as a string. And so I'm setting my erange. What I've done is I have on my, instead of having to, where my VLOOKUP is, I've already defined it in my code. So that's what my erange is, sheet 3, A2 to B13. I've defined sheet 1 as a data sheet, sheet 2 is a report sheet. Account number is what we're looking up, and that's what's reported in the sheet 2 A1 value. E address equals, so we're doing a VLOOKUP in the E address table, you're in the E range table. So it's application worksheet function VLOOKUP account number. E range is what I've defined up here. We want the second column and we want it to be false. It's telling it to put my E address in report sheet range B1, report sheet range A2 to G1000 clear. So if there's, we have anything in there from before, we're going to take it all out. Now we're going back to our data sheet, our data sheet being sheet one, okay? And then final rows, we're going to count up where the final row is. And then we're going to do a for statement for I equals 4 to final row. If cells I, first column, so that's I, the A thing, if it's account number, then what you're going to do is copy all this data. And then you're going to go to the report sheet and you're going to paste it. And we're using PasteSpecial format as number format and datasheet select. And then we're going through this loop till we get all it done. And now, after we've finished our loop here, we're going to select the report sheet. And then we're going to start our Outlook, set Outlook application, create object application, Outlook application create, set my attachment Outlook application. And then I've put my path number in here. Application display loots equals false, file name equals account number, which is what we were searching by, plus PDF, subject is account number, And then active sheet, I'm saving my active sheet as what we've searched for and got on that other one. And then we're saving that as a PDF. And then the Outlook to e-address that we've looked up in our VLOOK table, then we're carbon copy, blind carbon copy, or blank. Our subject is the account number. And then I have a little blurb here. Please find a copy of your transactions attached. And then best regards. And then we're going to go attachments add, Outlook items display. And normally you wouldn't have the apostrophe in front of the Outlook send. I just left it off so I could display my Outlook when it's going. Range A1 select so you can and go through there. So let's run this again. So let's go to sheet 2 and let's select, how about this one? And then what we're going to do is run it. So there we go. There we have our email sent. There we have our data that's copied from the first sheet. Our PDF is created for copying this sheet. And the previous sheet was cleared out. So that's how you select data from a master sheet, copy it to another sheet, email it, and that's how you select data or filter data from another sheet, copy it to a new sheet, save it as a PDF, and email it as an attachment. Please subscribe.